have your attention, please. If you can place your eyes to the rear of the hearse as the honor guard prepares to receive your loved one, transfer him over to our caisson. I'm going to take a step off to the side. Please remain here for just a moment.
Ready? Step.
Thank you.
have your attention, please. If you could place your eyes to the rear of the caisson as the honor guard prepares to receive your loved one, transfer him to his final resting place. Again, I'm going to take a step off to the side. Please remain here for just a moment.
Present arms. Ready? Step. Ready?
Listen, I'm gonna write this way.
Man, this first chair right here in the front row for you to get the fucking shit.
Mark time. Bears. Halt.
And that first chair for you.
Ready?
Immediate family, I invite you forward to come fill in those chairs provided. Everyone else, you're welcome to come along the sides and back of the chair.
Ready? Now.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am Father Leo Morris, and it is my honor and privilege to be with you today as we lay to rest our beloved brother and comrade in arms, Colonel Thomas Jerome Hogan. The soldiers you see rendering honors are from the 3rd United States Infantry Regiment, known as the Old Guard. This is the Army's oldest active duty infantry unit. We welcome you to Arlington National Cemetery. Our nation has rendered honors to our fallen warriors and patriots for over 150 years. These sacred grounds are a lasting tribute to the men and women who have faithfully served our nation. There are over 400,000 Americans buried here. As you look out over the rows of headstones in the cemetery and in the walls of the columbarium, each stone is a brick in the foundation of freedom upon which we stand today. I encourage you to remember this. No eternal resting place at Arlington National Cemetery can be purchased. Each must be earned. It is our sincere hope and prayer that among these hallowed grounds, we celebrate the life of Thomas with dignity and reverence. Thomas answered our nation's call to serve in the preservation of our heritage of freedom, and he served with honor and distinction during the turbulent years of the Vietnam War. And for his honorable service with the United States Army, he received numerous military awards and decorations, most notably the Air Medal. For our comrade in arms, Colonel Thomas Jerome Hogan, our nation bestows military honors. In life, he honored the flag. Now this flag will honor him.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for military honors. The firing party's in front of you to the left. The bugler is over to the right. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated.
Ready?
Ready! Ma'am, on behalf of the President of the United States Army, and the grateful nation, please accept this flag as a symbol of our appreciation for your loved one's honorable and faithful service.
Ms. Hogan, my name is Jill McGovern, and on behalf of the Army Chief of Staff in Mississippi-Conville, the Army Arlington ladies, and our entire Army family, I'd like to express our condolences to
you so much.
I'm sure that your husband was so very proud of your family. What a wonderful tribute to have so many friends here. And I know you were part of his service, too. How many generations do you have here?
Wonderful. The little ones are even here.
Oh, but that's tribute. Okay. So please accept that. Condolences.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our brother Tom has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope and eternal life, let us also assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our brother. Together, may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. We read in sacred scripture, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, says the Lord, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world." Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you have hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our brother may sleep here in peace, until you waken him to glory. For you are the resurrection and the life. Then he will see you face to face, and in your light will see light, and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Because God has chosen to call our brother Tom from this life to himself, we now commit his body to the earth. For we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. For he is risen, the firstborn of the dead. Let us commend our brother to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise his body up on the last day. For our brother Tom, let us pray to the Lord Jesus, who said, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall live even in death, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die." Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Tom, and dry the tears of all who weep. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, you wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you raise the dead to life. Give to our brother eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you promised paradise to the repentant thief. Bring Tom to the joys of heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, our brother was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give him fellowship with all your saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, Tom was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table of your heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, comfort us in our sorrow at the death of Tom. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life be our hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant Tom. Do not count his deeds against him, for in his heart he desired to do your will. As his faith united him to your people on earth, so may your mercy join him to the angels in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant on him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May Tom rest in peace. Amen.
Amen.
And may his soul and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless this dwelling place until the day of the resurrection. The Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Father.
Thanks, Father.
The honor guard wanted you to have the rifle casings fired from the service today.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely. It's my absolute privilege and pleasure to be here with you for your service. If you or your family needs absolutely anything, please don't hesitate to reach out to me, okay?
Thank you.
It's my privilege.
Ladies and gentlemen, this does conclude our service. On behalf of the immediate family, I would like to thank each and every one of you for taking time out of your busy schedules to be here on this significant. We're here in Arlington National Cemetery in Section 55. Just off to my left side, underneath the green carpet, is grave number 1054. Thomas Jerome Hogan, Colonel, United States Army, final resting place. Ladies and gentlemen, if you would like to come forward and pay any final respects before heading back to your vehicles, I invite you to do so at this time. Thank you. Thank you.
He's right by a tree. He's like Steve.